It's difficult for Jehovah's Witnesses to identify themselves as a cult. One reason is that they do not have one charismatic leader for the entire organization, which is true. They have about nine that are the governing body members that are in the forefront on their major videos, giving talks on their podcasts on JW.org, and when they upload convention talks featuring the various governing body members. And yes, the congregation members do form attachments to these leaders. It's like anyone who's in the public arena. People form attachments and they gain followers, like the entertainment industry and sports industry, which are obvious ones. But are there cult leaders in those industries? Well, the answer could be yes. Now, I'm not talking about any obsessed preteen or teenager who might have rock stars or sports stars' photos plastered on their walls. Normally, that is a phase. But what about adults who are for a particular sports team and resort to violence to promote that team? Sometimes at sporting events, the various fans will literally fight and kill to defend a team. That might be a sign you're involved in cultish behavior, which the masters of these sports teams wants. They want fans obsessed with the teams because if everyone were just a casual observer, they would hardly sell tickets or get sponsors to these events or get them on TV. It's organized worship. Pick your poison. Who or what do you worship? It can be anything that becomes obsessive to the point where no one can disagree with you. Like if someone orders strawberry ice cream and the table next to you and you have a fit, well, then the problem would be with me, not with the person with the differing tastes. So, what is the point? Governments use this to predict behavior. They want you in a certain group, a certain cult. It's almost like a social study, yet they use those results to turn them into dollars and cents. Yes, they know who'll buy what merchandise at any given time. But when we talk about religion, the governments already can predict how each major group will react to a new law, a regulation, a new policy, even who will serve in the military when they want to stage a conflict. They know who'll say no, like the Jehovah's Witnesses. They know who will dodge out and go into hiding and who will gladly accept military duty. It's everyone sectioned off into groups of predictable behavior. Like when to stage a massive lockdown for a perceived health threat, which would main probably wouldn't have worked maybe 20 years ago. But studying trends, they know when to strike, when the sheep are ready to be herded into their pens. So you Jehovah's Witnesses out there, you are being tagged and flagged by governments. It has little to do with any political party, which can be cult-like in itself. It has to do with predictability. They know the Christians will oppose abortion. They know liberals will support it. This is all counting numbers games. Oh, gee, maybe they were wrong. Maybe some middle-of-the-road Christians support abortion. Then they study that with predicted outcomes. Even if you ever call for jury duty, the guy sitting there reading a Christian magazine, he won't be called to appear on the jury. If they are, they'll ask what he's reading. The second they hear about God, that guy is dismissed. Why? It's because they already know his predictable decision in any court case. Try it for yourself. Say nothing if questioned for jury selection. You might be asked, what are your hobbies? You could say, I prefer to keep them private. Okay, do you read newspapers? I prefer to keep my reading material private. Guess what? You will be shown the door out of there in no time. Due to not being able to predict the outcome, you'll be tagged as a wild card and not able to be manipulated. It's all a form of manipulation and control. See your religion for what it is. Most JWs can and will become insane over anyone challenging the Watchtower's policies, even going so far as to defend the two-witness rule for cases of child abuse. They think some spirit named Jehovah is guiding matters as children continue to be abused. They think some man named Jesus is returning out of the clouds to rescue everyone. I mean, the beliefs are all over the map. But governments and special interest groups could not care less about all this. They do know the predictable outcome. And yes, you Jehovah Witness robots out there, you are programmed to respond to your cult leaders called the governing body. Take a step back and think for a second. Are your thoughts, opinions, and feelings about any subject, is it really your own, or put in place by the organization you worship? Only you can answer that, as millions are waking up to the reality they are not in control. But they actually dig deeper, look at certain rules and regulations, and can decipher when it's actually only a guideline or policy written by men who want to control your every thought, word, and action. Think about that, Jehovah's Witnesses, as you vacantly stare at your next JW video at the convention or Kingdom Hall or even on a Zoom camera, fixated on the droning of the speaker, the humming of the electronics, even the background music that's used to get you into trance. It's time to take a step back. Think about who owns your mind, heart, and soul. Have a good day.